Hey guys, welcome back to No Catch Name. It's me, Ella. Today is Wednesday, so it's Whatcha working on Wednesday. So today, I ended up, because it's later in the day, I don't know if you can tell, but the sun is setting, and I intended to film this earlier, and just life got in the way. So the WIP that I was working on today, I finished, but it's kind of wonky. So I was going to show, or you know, my WIP today was a soap sack. A cotton one. It's made out of this cotton yarn right here. I can't remember what this is called, but it's from Walmart. Is it the sugar and cream? My mom gave it to me a while ago. She gave me a bunch of yarn that she was using, and it's just a pretty pink color. So it doesn't have the band with it, so I don't know what the color is called. But it's like a dusty pink color. Big old cone. I've made a few things with it, and then I was wanting a soap sack to put a bar of soap in, and the pattern that I found that I wanted to try to make was a free one by Moogly, however you say it. And I thought it was cute, and I made it with an eye hook. It was a 5.5 millimeter hook. But somewhere along the way of me making it, I got off kilter a little bit. And so it's kind of twisted looking. So there are like bubble stitches. I don't know if you can see that good, but they're kind of leaning. All of her images of them, they were straight. I noticed that it was doing that, but I didn't think it was a big deal because it's a soap sack. And it's not one that I'm like gifting anybody. It's one I was going to keep and use personally. So, so I did make it. I haven't woven in the ends yet. There's still two ends there. And it does have like a little drawstring for you to put the bar soap in and then you know, cinch it up. So it's still usable. It's just funky looking. So it's a pretty easy pattern. I just messed it up along the way. My problem was I was working on it while watching TV while also dealing with my 16-month-old. So I was distracted a lot. And I think what it was is because you're supposed to like turn each row. I think I was working into the wrong stitch every time I turned. So it just kind of put it off a stitch each row. So that's why they're just kind of jogged over one stitch each. But like I said, I'm not too worried about it. It's not a big deal. So I'm gonna weave in the ends and I'm still going to use it because it's just like if I was gifting it to someone, I would rip it out and try to do it right. But it's just a soap sack, so it doesn't need to be perfect. But anyway, yeah, so I'll leave that link below if you want to check it out, the pattern. I was just on Ravelry looking for some, and this one stood out to me because it had the little baubles on it. I just felt like that would be good, you know, for cleaning. and then the other thing I was gonna start, I haven't got to start it yet because we ended up having to run a couple errands when Devin got home from work, and we went grocery shopping as well. Because I forgot, I try to make a menu every week, the week prior, you know, for what we're going to make for dinner. And I had a recipe on there that I completely forgot to get the ingredients for, and it's what I'm making tomorrow. So I had to go, the only things I forgot was cream cheese and a little can of green chilies, making taquitos. and so I had to go to the store to get those. But, and then we ended up just getting everything else too over there. All the groceries for next week. But anyways, the next project that I want to start today, if I get a chance, I gotta get the kids baths and stuff. And I would really like to get myself a shower today, but we'll see if I'll get to. Is the Repeat Crafter Me, my thingy just went off. Repeat Crafter Me May Square. My sticking tripod has a short in the wire. I've had it since Christmas time 2021, and I think it's just, you know, it was just a $20 one. Okay, I guess start. what was I saying? Repeat Crafter Me May Square for the animal square blanket is a frog. It is so cute. I think it'd be cute as a blanket on its own. You could make like different color frogs and maybe like solid color squares in between them, and it would be really cute. But I hit this one out because the lighting now is real shadowy. Come on, work. I don't know where the short's at. Whoop, I just shook y'all. Come on. It lights up and then it dies again. If I could figure out where it's at, I could maybe fix it. I don't know what part of the wire it's in. Okay, anyways. I pulled up the yarn for it. Now, I do not have any more light color green. I mentioned this, I think, in a recent video. And I don't want to, like, necessarily just order another one or anything. I looked in my local Walmart. Oh, dang it. I had it. And, they didn't have any. They didn't have any red heart spring green. They didn't have any of the mainstays green. So I don't want to order just a ball of yarn to do that. And also my leaves and stems for the strawberry plant that I was making that I have to put a pause on because I don't have any yarn to do that. So I haven't got the chance to go to Hobby Lobby to look to see if they got like a light green in their yarn or Crafter's Secret or whatever. So maybe I'll do that if I get to go to that town anytime soon. But until then, anyways, to make the frog, I just pulled out these colors. So for the frog's body, I think I'm going to use this color. This is Red Heart Medium Time. It's also falling apart. And then for the border, because the border is another color green, I pulled out Patty Green. It might be a little too bright. It's a little bit brighter in person. I might try to see if I got another, like a scrap ball of the darker, like evergreen or something like that to do that with. I don't know. But anyways, that's the color I'm going to make the frog. So I might sit down and try to work on that today and hopefully get it going. And I got a couple of evergreens that I've been working on to share with you guys on Friday. What's tomorrow? Tomorrow's Thursday. I don't think I have a video planned for tomorrow, but I might. If I get a chance to film during the day, I might try to record something. And yeah, I guess that's it. That's all I've been working on. So let me know down in the comments what you what you guys have been working on, and feel free to share any links or people or patterns or whatever. And yeah, if you want to share your WIP's progress with me via photograph, you can do it on the Facebook group, which is always in the description box, or you can email them to me in my email, which is always on in the description box. Or if you're on Instagram, you could tag me in it. My Instagram is also linked below. You could tag me in it, and that way I can see what you're making. And I like seeing other people's WIPs, and it gives me ideas of things that I want to make. So yeah, I'm going to go. I'm sitting here holding my wire in my hand because the way I'm holding it is keeping it on. I'm going to go put all this stuff up. I need to weave in these ends, and I need to, well, I don't need to, but I want to start on this, but I got other things to do. I did two loads of laundry today, and I swept the house like 3 times. The kids are so messy, I swear. And just constantly, like, I feel like I'm just constantly going behind them and picking up stuff, especially June, because she's, you know, she's 16 months now, so she's in that age where she's getting into everything. And I don't, you know, we have our apartment baby proofed, but not like 1,000%. So she's constantly opening up the entertainment drawers and entertainment center drawers, pulling out stuff or bookshelves and stuff. So I'm just constantly going behind her, picking everything up. And, but anyways, they're outside right now. Devin's got them outside. Jessie's playing and June is in playing her little splash water bucket thing pool. But yeah, I'm going to hop off here and I'll catch up with you guys maybe tomorrow, but for sure Friday I'll see you again. And, yeah, let me know what you're working on, and I guess that's it. Bye, guys.